Okay, number 34, we're going to take a look at what is sine, if you know what cosine is, and you know it's in quadrant 4. A couple ways to do this problem, and one would be the Pythagorean identity, which says that the sine squared plus the cosine squared always equals 1. Okay, so if we know the cosine is 3/5, we can substitute 3/5 in for cosine, or C in this problem, and solve for S. So 3/5 squared is 9 over 25. And if we subtract 9 25ths from both sides, we get 16 25ths. And then finally, if you take the square root of both sides, you get 4 fifths. So if the cosine is 3/5, the sine must be 4/5. If it's in quadrant 4, we know that down in quadrant 4, the sine has to be negative. So the answer would be negative 4/5. Okay? Another way to do this problem. Let's draw it. Draw the triangle on the unit circle. Well, let's just sort of draw it on the grid here. If we know that the cosine is 3/5 and we're in quadrant 4, okay, remember that cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. So that means that the adjacent is 3 and the hypotenuse is 5. 3, 5. So the question then is, what would the sine be? Well, if this is our angle and adjacent over hypotenuse is 3/5, we could use the Pythagorean theorem to find this missing side, 4. Because you know that 3 squared, 9, plus 4 squared, 16, should equal 5 squared, 25. Now that you know that this is 4, the sine would equal the opposite. So the opposite would be 4 over the adjacent, over the hypotenuse, which is 5. And since we're going downward into quadrant 4, we know that the sine must be negative. So negative 4/5 is the answer, whether you use the Pythagorean identity or the drawing that I have on the board right now.